After elections in different countries where more or less populist leaders won, many people are asking why did it happen. And of course, as I'm a sociologist, I'm sure that we always should remember that social phenomena have no one simple explanation, but I want to concentrate on some of possible explanation of this phenomenon. And first, we should investigate on the reasons for voting for populists, and we think only about impact of fake news or social networks, but I also means of spreading this fake news. We are missing something important, I think, because many people feel that the government can provide security in the daily life, security for the future of the citizens, of the next generations also. And people, in fact, are afraid. It is especially visible in the region I came from the Western Europe, Eastern and Central Europe. And these fears of people are connected with economy, social security, jobs, future challenges for our children. But people are also afraid of the dishonesty of the ruling elite and the media related to that elite. And if you feel that somebody is cheating you, you can try to find another a source of information that is independent of official media, such as, of course, social networks and internet. And sometimes you can fall into the trap of fake news. And I think in my country, in the region, we face, in fact, the epidemic of untrust. And some decades ago, a sociologist Ulrich Beck wrote a book about the society of risk. And he showed how management of risk is used to controlling the society. And now we have, I think, society of untrust. And some political leaders learn how to win by social management of that untrust and of social fears. And another problem is the deep, profound divisions among society. In Poland, it is especially visible in the significant divisions between rural population and the inhabitants of a big city. And it is also connected with the problem of social networks, because they are wonderful, really wonderful tools for bringing people together. But they can also easily create close communities. Close communities of people with similar thinking and similar way of seeing things. And people are talking with the others that think in the same way. They share the news that are confirm their point of view. They support opinions and comments of people they like. And they can easily exclude people that they don't agree with. And it is easier in the internet than in the real life, in fact, to exclude the people that think in a different way. And that is the reason why fake news work, because they can be easily circulated between people from closed network of similar thinking people and without chance to confront with different views. So when using the internet and social networks in internet, people feel that they have access to the whole world. But in fact, they often have access only to what they were chosen and they liked. And what was chosen by people similar to them. So I think, especially in the example of my country, that we need education on critical usage of new media. And not only in the aspect of personal data, of money, of payment in the internet, but we have to learn how to actively search for information and not only passively read and circulate.